Found the missing patrols, or was something else on your mind? They were all dead then. I suppose I'm not surprised. We have few friends in the world above, and many enemies. But we must turn our minds to other matters. When I sent out those patrols, I also sent three knights out on scouting missions. When the patrols failed to return, we assumed the worst, and sent a single communication to the scouts to hold position and maintain radio silence. I want you to contact those scouts and gather their reports. Like the patrols, they have devices on them that will enable you to track them. When you find them, tell them you're my representative and ask them if the bears are still hunting. That should get them to talk to you. Return when you've gathered all of their reports.
We won't go quiet.
Yeah? Military operations are classified information. Some powder gangers did you wrong, is that it? Get in line. Still, you do look capable enough, and manpower hasn't been easy to come by. All right, fine by me if you want to put yourself in harm's way. I'll mark the staging area on your map. Talk to Sergeant Lee.
Quietly. The Legion can count on that.
Thank you. I'm Sergeant Lee. Lieutenant Hayes radioed ahead to say you were on the way. We've got surprise on our side, and that's about it. Once we blow a gap in the fence, we've got to pour on the fire and keep them disorganized. Our goal is to take out their leader, some assbag named Eddie. With the ringleader gone, the rest will fold. And that's all the briefing you're going to get. Let's go.
Trouble.
Patrolling the Mojave almost makes you wish for a nuclear winter.
Patrolling the Mojave almost makes you wish for a nuclear winter.
Morning.
We can take it from here. We might have some cleaning up to do, but Eddie's a deady. Gangs with no leadership don't last long. I'll radio Hayes to let him know the prison's ours. But you should swing by to see him the next time you're near Prim.
Morning.
Patrolling the Mojave almost makes you wish for a nuclear winter. Morning.
Morning.
Trouble.
What do you want? And don't try anything funny. You speak truly, for it is unlikely that an outsider would know both the Elder's name and that passphrase. Very well. I've been observing the penal facility there in the distance for some time now, after having followed some rather disturbing rumors. Eventually, the NCR got around to putting the prisoners down, but not until they had wreaked havoc on nearby trade routes. Eventually, the NCR got around to putting the prisoners down, but not until they had wreaked havoc on nearby trade routes. Give this to the Elder. My observations are all within. Perhaps he will have a better idea of what this situation portends. That report must reach the Elder's hands. I have nothing further to give you.
Hey. Don't take another step if you value your life. For what purpose do you approach me? Strange that the Elder should send an outsider, but I suppose he has his reasons. My observations have mostly focused on the small town to the south of here. It was cruelly attacked, its inhabitants slain nearly to the last. That such an act could occur so far west is nearly unthinkable. The NCR has forces in all directions, and an outpost scant miles west from here. That they have not responded to this violence shows either an unwillingness or inability to properly defend their borders, which is telling. I've collected such musings in this report. Please take it to the Elder.
Ordinary guys with knives and bullets, and they're taking over Nevada.
Hold up there. This area is locked down by the NCR military until we can dislodge some Legion snakes from Nelson. My apologies, but that name and face ain't ringing the old school bell upstairs. Afraid I can't let you through until the situation is resolved. Fair enough. It's not like any of the troopers around here are jumping up to volunteer. If you had a few dozen doses of Psycho on you, maybe we could pep those weepy troopers into charging down into Nelson and taking back the camp. But since that's not likely, you could help me take out the Legion's trooper hostages. I'm a ranger. They're troopers. Different branches. I don't have authority over them, even though they're as green as a super mutant's backside. Besides, they'd probably start crying as soon as they saw the hostages get so much as a bruise. Nope, they don't got the stomach for it. The troopers won't go down into camp with their comrades at risk. Dirty game, the Legion likes to roll out whenever they get a chance. Problem is, Ranger Milo doesn't want to play. If we take out the hostages, they've got squat for leverage. Back at Ranger School, they taught us not to run headlong into a battle when you're outnumbered 10-1. You want to go down there and try to haul those crippled boys off those poles? You're dumber than you look. That's a shame. Well, let me know if you change your mind, or those Legion sons of bitches will be holed up in Nelson for weeks. What's on your mind? Troopers tried moving down from Forlorn Hope because we got this big gap between there and Searchlight. Turns out we were spread too thin. We took our sweet-ass time setting up in Nelson, and the Legion managed to hop over the Colorado and attack before things were settled. There's Novak due west. Just look for the Big Lizard. They got some decent supplies and a place to stay. The 188's north on the 95. Good for all kinds of trade. Not much south on 95 unless you turn west on 164 to Nipton. Right off the rail line. Nope, I'm just the only ranger around. The rest of the kids here are troopers. Inexperienced, outnumbered, and under-equipped. Hey, hold on. Just so you know, if you go down into that camp, one of two things is gonna happen. Either that little head of yours is gonna sail into the Colorado courtesy of a Legion machete, or they're gonna try to make friends with you. And if I find out you're friends with the Legion, I'll put a lump of lead through your skull as soon as you pop it back up over the ridge. Are we clear? Much obliged.
Hello.
For the Brotherhood!